If we started to see things that we call addictions as just a series of choices in every moment, then altering an addiction, in quotes, into a different kind of behavior comes a lot easier to even conceptualize. People say, I'm addicted to food. I'm addicted to prescription medication. I'm addicted to drugs. Hey, I'm addicted to sex. I'm addicted to love. And then we have all kinds of groups for people who have various addictions. I notice that addictions are about everything we disapprove of. So let me give you a contrary example. I exercise and have exercised for decades pretty much every day. People never say you're addicted to taking care of yourself. You know what they tell me? They say, hey, you're very disciplined. And I realized what we're saying is anything we choose to do over and over again that we approve of, we actually identify as being disciplined. We're a disciplined person. Anything that we do over and over again, smoking a cigarette, drinking alcohol, but we disapprove of that, we then say, well, wow, you're addicted. So, the crucial difference between addiction and discipline is judgment. Isn't that incredible? Years ago, I wrote a book called To Love Is To Be Happy With, and I've written a dozen books. That book started with a little piece that I put right in the front of the book, and it said, the difference between a flower and a weed is a judgment. In effect, the difference is how we look at it. Now, why this is really, really significant is because when we look at the things we call discipline, we always think we have choice. That's why we're doing it. When we actually put things in the category of addiction, we always think we don't have a choice. But I'm going to suggest that every time we do it, just like a discipline, we're actually making a choice. If we started to see things that we call addictions as just a series of choices in every moment, then altering an addiction, in quotes, into a different kind of behavior comes a lot easier to even conceptualize. How do you change an addiction? Convert it into something you would prefer to do? Here's the kicker. When you're doing the thing you're calling addiction, that's actually what you prefer to do at the moment. But if you assess what actually you get from doing that behavior, you might want to alter it and change it. How do you do that? You have to figure out how to make a different choice. How do you make a different choice? You have to change the beliefs that you have. So if I believe making the choice for that piece of pie or that alcohol or that cigarette right now is a way to nourish me right now, and I'm looking for immediate gratification, and immediate gratification by my belief system is really important, then I'll keep making that choice. If I decide being healthy, being clear-headed, being happy is very important, and that becomes my guiding belief principles, then the next time I make a choice, I said, is this going to lead to my health? Is this going to lead to my happiness? Now you might say, please, that's so unrealistic. I'm going to suggest it isn't necessarily unrealistic unless you believe it's unrealistic. What about the idea that we just pause for a moment and we say to ourselves, okay, it's a choice. And every time I do it, it's a choice. It's not a mountain. It's not a flood. It's not a hurricane. It just seems like in every present moment, I can have an opportunity to do something different. How's that sound? Even if it sounds a little bit strange for the moment, just give yourself a moment and say, a choice. Every time I do that, it's a choice. Every time I do that, it's a choice. It's a choice. It's a choice. It's always a choice, which means we're always in charge. And I think that is not bad news. That's good news. Actually, no, that's great news. Have fun with this.